will continue, but with limited to no spectators, all because of these same coronavirus concerns.
Fox 59's Kelly Rinke actually shows us why they made this unprecedented decision.
After the NBA suspended its season and the Big Ten Conference canceled its tournament, it's not really surprising that they made this move, but the IHSAA says right now it's not necessary to postpone the games.
We appreciate your understanding and support during these challenging times.
Another precautionary measure shows just how serious people are taking the coronavirus outbreak. IHSAA following the NBA and the Big Ten Conference, making unprecedented decisions just 2 days before its state tournaments.
Primary focus has been and will continue to be the health and safety of our students and supporters attending our events.
Commissioner Bobby Cox explains it is limiting events to about 250 people. That means fewer spectators at the boys' basketball state tournament. Each school will only get 75 complimentary tickets. That's aside from players. The tickets will only be for immediate family, school staff, and coaches.
The principal and athletic director shall screen eligible individuals from each participating school for entrance into the facility. The host site is encouraged to designate separate entrances for each school.
A big change in gameplay just days before regionals. And for the girls' gymnastics state finals on Saturday, no fans will be allowed inside.
When you count up all the participants, all the judges, all the spotters, all the scorers, everybody that's going to be in that arena, we're already at 250 before we let the first person in.
Right now, the tournaments will continue even with limited or no fans. IHSAA does not believe it's time to cancel the events.
Last time I checked the Indiana Department of Health, 15 of our 16 sites have no confirmed cases in those counties. I feel pretty comfortable about the regionals. Now, this may change moving forward.
Understanding there's a possibility that more difficult decisions could be made.
If we can get through this week and we feel confident that we can move forward, we'll do the Sima State the same way.
This decision also takes a hard hit to IHSAA's funding. They believe this will cost them roughly $500,000. Reporting on the north side, I'm Kelly Rinke, Fox 59 News.
All right, a lot of people thinking about these events.